Hello dear students, welcome to the another lecture of applied mechanics. Today we are going to discuss about the next problems, which is based on the law of parallelogram. So in the previous lecture we have discussed about the law of parallelogram and the problem based on it and resultant of the forces. So let's go to our next problem, that is problem number 6. Here read the problem carefully. What problem said to us? A triangle ABC has its side AB is equal to 40 mm along positive x axis and side BC is equal to 30 mm along positive y axis. So here two lengths are given to us, then three forces of 40 newton, 50 newton and 30 newton act along the sides AB, BC and CA respectively. Determine magnitude of the resultant of such a system of forces. So we have to find out the magnitude of the resultant. So first thing we have to do is to find out the given data. So write down the given data, what given data is. So here you can see from the geometry of the figure. So here we can draw a figure from these values. So here you have to draw the figure for that. So this is your 40 newton force. One is the 40 newton force, second one is the 50 newton force. Here is the 50 newton force and third one is the, how much it is, a 30 newton force. So from here this is the 30 newton. So these are the three axes. Here you can see what it said, the line AB 40 mm along the x axis. So this is the AB line, that is nothing but the 40 mm along the x axis. After that what it said, side BC is 30 mm along y axis. So this is your y axis. So on this 30 mm, that is B to C. And CA is nothing but the respective, here your angle is theta and this is the your 90 degree angle. So it is a right angle triangle. So now what we have to do, we have to find out the magnitude of the resultant of system of forces. So here from this figure, from the geometry of figure, from the geometry of figure, we find that the triangle ABC is nothing but the right angle triangle. ABC is a right angle triangle. So this is the right angle triangle. So when we have a right angle triangle and we know the two sides, one is the AB and BC, so we can find out the CA side by using the Pythagoras theorem. So we have to use here the Pythagoras theorem. So what Pythagoras theorem said to us, hypotenuse square is equal to opposite side square divided by adjacent sides square. So here theta is nothing but our angle. So this is your opposite side and this is your adjacent side and this is the hypotenuse. So write down the Pythagoras theorem. So here what it is, AC square is equal to, that is hypotenuse, is equal to adjacent side AB square plus BC square. So this is your values. Okay, so this is your formula for the what? Pythagoras. So here put the all values. Here AC square is unknown to us. AB is nothing but the 40 mm. So here 40 bracket square plus BC is a 30 mm, so 30 bracket square. So now resolve these values or calculate these all values. 40 square is nothing but the 1600 plus 30 square is nothing but the 900, right? Now AC square is nothing but the 2500. So then take a square root of this value. So it will be a AC is equal to how much? 50 mm. So this is the value of AC. So now we get the third length value, third line value, that is the hypotenuse is nothing but the 50 mm, right? Now here you can see, so this theta is also unknown to us, so we can find out the theta also. So take a formula for sine theta is equal to what is opposite side divided by hypotenuse. Recently we have found out the hypotenuse. Now we can find out the sine theta or theta value by using this equation. Sine theta is equal to opposite side divided by hypotenuse, right? So what is the opposite side? The value of opposite side is nothing but the sine theta is equal to value of opposite side is nothing but 30 mm and value of hypotenuse is nothing but the 50 mm. So put both values here. So opposite side is the 30 divided by hypotenuse 50, right? Now calculate this, it will be a 0.6. Now you can also find cos theta value. So here cos theta is equal to, that is the adjacent side divided by hypotenuse. So here adjacent is 40 and hypotenuse is 50, so it will be a 0.8. so this is the values for sine theta and cos theta. So now we have to resolve the, we have to find out the magnitude of resultant forces. So while we finding the resultant forces, first thing we have to do to resolve the forces in a horizontally, after that vertically. So we know the all steps for finding the magnitudes and resultants of the forces. We have discussed in the law of parallelogram, all steps I have given to you. So just follow that steps here. So first thing, resolving all the forces horizontally. You have to resolve all the forces horizontally, right? So here you can resolve the all forces horizontally. So here summation of Fx for horizontal. So how we can resolve the forces? This is the 40 Newton goes towards the right side. So this is the 40 Newton, that is horizontal. Here you can write 40 minus, why minus? This is the 50 is vertical, but this 30 Newton is a inclination, right? So we can take it. So from here we can resolve this like this. One is on a horizontal line and one is on a vertical, one is on a vertical line. So this is nothing but 30 cos theta and this is nothing but the 30 sin theta, right? So firstly we have resolving the horizontal forces. So take it 30 cos theta. In which direction it goes? It goes in a left direction, means minus direction in second quadrant. So that's why we have taking a minus sign here. So minus 30 cos of theta, right? So here 40 minus 30 and cos of theta is nothing but the 0.8, right? So here multiplied by 0.8. Now do the calculation in your calci and find out the value of summation of fx, that is nothing but the 16 Newton. So this is the horizontal forces, summation of horizontal forces. Now we have to resolve the vertical forces also. So here resolving all the forces vertical. So now we have to resolve all the forces vertically. So here summation of Fy is equal to nothing but the 50 minus vertical forces, that is 30 into sine theta. How we can take this? So you can see here, this is the vertical forces towards the upside, means positive 50. After that, this inclined force we can resolve one is horizontal and one is vertical. So this vertical sine 30, but it goes in a downward direction, means negative direction. That's why we have taken here negative minus 30 sine theta. Now this sine theta is nothing but the 0.6. Recently we have find out here, right? So take that value. So here summation of Fy is equal to 50 minus 30 into 0.6. So do the calculation in your calc. You will get the value of summation of Fy, that is nothing but the 32 Newton. So this is the value of horizontal and vertical resolutions. Now we have to find out the resultant, right? So here we know formula for that. What formula? We know that magnitude of resultant force is nothing but, what formula we can use? R is equal to under root of summation of fx square plus summation of fy square. So this is the formula, right? For what? For magnitude of resultant forces. So now put the values in this equation. What value we have find out for fx and fy? Put that values here. So here in bracket 16 square plus 32 square. So this is the value of summation of fx and this is the value of summation of fy. So now do the calculation of this term. R is equal to nothing but the under root of 256 plus 1024. Right? After that, addition of these two terms, that is nothing but the 1280. And now take a under root and you will get the value of R is nothing but the 35.77 Newton. So this is the value for the magnitude of the force. So this term we have to find out and we have determined that term. So this is the procedure for finding the resultant of the magnitude of force. So based on this, you can solve the number of problems. So now let's see the some different kind of problem. So here you can see the different problem. I hope you understand the procedure of this problem number six terms. So now we are going to discuss about the problem number seven. To see on the screen, your problem number six is: a system of forces are acting at the corners of a rectangular block as shown in figure. So we have given the system of the forces, right, which are acting at the corners rectangularly. So figure is given to us and they are asking us about the determine the magnitude and direction of the resultant of force. So in the previous problem they are asking us about only magnitude. Here they are asking us about magnitude as well as direction of the resultant force. So we have to find out magnitude and direction also. So first thing we have to do is nothing but to find out the given data. But figure is given to us here, right? So you don't need to draw the figure. So what you have to find out? Given data. So you have to find out the magnitude, that is the R is equal to how much and theta is equal to how much. Magnitude of resultant and direction of resultant, in which direction your resultant force is acting. So now first thing we have to do is a magnitude of the resultant force. Magnitude of resultant force, right? So here you have to do what you have to do: resolving forces horizontally. First we have to resolve all the forces horizontally. After that we have to resolve all the forces vertically. So that is nothing but summation of fx is equal to. So now you can see here horizontal forces. This one is the horizontal and this one is the horizontal. This and this is a vertical forces. So we can take only two horizontal forces. That is this force 25 is goes towards the first quadrant means right side means this is the positive sign, and this is goes towards the left side means second quadrant. So this is the negative sign. So here our force would be like 25 minus 20, right? So the value of this is nothing but the 5 newton. Sorry, kilonewton. The forces are mentioned in a kilonewton. So this is not a newton only. This is a kilonewton, right? So again, resolving forces vertically. So that is nothing but the summation of y is equal to. So here you can see this 50 is a, it goes to the downward, and this 35 is also goes to the downward. So both forces are in a negative. So here your force would be like minus 50 minus 35. So it is nothing but the minus 85 kilonewton. So this is the value of summation of y. So here we get the summation of fx and summation of fy. Now what we can do, now we have to find out the resultant. So we know that, we know the formula for that. So here we know that magnitude of resultant force, magnitude of resultant force, right? So here what is formula for that? R is equal to under root of summation fx square plus summation of fy square, right? So here R is equal to under root of, put the value of both terms. So fx is nothing but the 5 square plus here minus 85 square, right? So now here you can see R is equal to under root of 25 plus square of 85, that is nothing but the 7225. Now do the addition of these both terms. So that will be nothing but the R is equal to under root of 7250. Right. Now take a square root of this term, you will get the value of R. So you have to do all these calculations in your Calc. So here the value of R is nothing but the 85.15 kilonewton. Just do the calculation by yourself. There will be a slightly changes in these values. Okay. Now second thing we have to do is the to find out the what direction of the resultant forces. So here B is nothing but the direction of resultant force. So here let we know theta is equal to angle which the resultant force, angle which the resultant force makes with horizontal line, or you can say horizontal axis, right? So now we know that, what we know, we know the formula of the direction of resultant forces. Means what formula is that? That is nothing but the tan theta is equal to summation of fy divided by summation of fx. So put the value of both terms. Here summation of fy is nothing but the minus 85 divided by 5. So it would be like minus 17, right? So now theta is equal to tan inverse of minus 70. Now do the calculation of this. For finding the inverse value, you can do just press the shift button of your calculator and after that press the tan button. So that will be the value of tan inverse. So theta is equal to nothing but the 86.6 degree. So this is the value of theta, but this is not a final value of your theta. So what direction is what direction your resultant force have actually? So here we have find out theta is nothing but the 86.6 degree. So this is not our actual direction. So how we can find out the actual direction? So you can see here, since summation of fx is positive, we have seen our summation of fx is positive and summation of fy is negative, right? This term is negative. Therefore resultant lines between 270 degree and 360 degree, cause x axis is negative. So suppose this is our quadrant, x axis is positive, so this is our positive axis, and y axis is negative, so this is our negative axis. So your direction would be in a fourth quadrant. So this is the 270 and this is 360. So in between this, your direction is. So now, thus actual angle of resultant force is equal to 360 minus 86.6. So do the calculation of it and it will be a 273.4 degree. So this is the value of the direction. So this is your value of direction of the resultant forces. So this is the problem number 7, which is a little bit different from the previous problem. Then let's see the another problem based on it, that will be again different from the previous two problems. So once you get the concept of these different problems, you will be able to solve the number of problems based on it. So in your examination, there will be the problem similar, but the values would be a change. Okay, value will be changed, or same problem will be asked in your examination. So here the problem number 8. So read the problem carefully. What problem said to you? The following forces act at a point. First one is the 20 Newton inclined at 30 degree towards the northeast. Second is the 25 Newton towards the north. After that, 30 Newton towards the northwest. And fourth one, 35 Newton inclined at 40 degree towards the south of west. Find the magnitude and the direction of the resultant forces. So here we have given a description. Based on this description, we have to draw one figure. So what it said, like that you have to prepare a diagram. So first thing what we have to do, we have to find out the magnitude of resultant, means r is equal to how much and theta is equal to how much. So just prepare the diagram for this. What it said, 20 Newton inclined at the towards northeast. So first you have to draw the one horizontal line and one vertical line, right? So this is your east direction, this is your west direction, this is north, and this is south, right? So now just read the problem, what it describes. 20 newton inclined at 30 degree towards northeast. So here you have to take 20 newton inclined towards the northeast. Here is the north and east. So here your 20 newton force is like this, towards northeast 20 newton, and angle is given to you, that is 30 degree, right? After that, 25 newton towards the north. So 25 newton towards the north. So this is nothing but your towards north, that is 25 newton, right? After that, 30 newton towards the northwest. So here, 30 newton towards the northwest with angle 30 newton towards the northwest, and 35 newton inclined to 40 degree towards the southwest. So here your diagram would be like 35 newton towards the southwest, that is nothing but the 35 newton, and here 30 newton towards the northwest. Okay, so just if this diagram you have drawn, after that you will be able to find out the what problem by using the formula. So which formula you can use, what problem formulas we have discussed in the law of parallelogram. So first thing you have to do is nothing but the find out the A, magnitude of the resultant forces. Magnitude of resultant forces. So first thing, resolving all the forces vertically. Resolving all forces vertically. So that is nothing but summation of Fx is equal to. So I have told you how you can resolve the forces. Each force you have to take in a two direction. So this is the cos 20 cos 30, and this is the 20 sin 30. Like this, you have to resolve all the forces. I hope you know that. So I have resolving all the forces, 20 cos of 30 minus 20 cos of 45, right? After that, minus 35 cos of 40. And just take the value of all these forces, right? So 20 cos of 30 is nothing but the 17.32. This is nothing but the minus 21.21, and the value of 35 minus 35 cos 40 is nothing but the minus 26.81. So here your summation of Fx is nothing but the minus 30.7 newton. So this is your horizontal force value. Now you have to resolve the forces in a vertical. So here, resolving all the forces vertically. So here, summation of Fy is nothing but the 25 plus 30 sin of 45, 30 sin of 45 plus, sorry, minus 35 sin of 40. So take the value of it, that is nothing but the one term is remaining here. This is the 30 sin of 45, and this is the 20 sin of 30. So this is remaining, that is the plus 20 sin of 30. So here 25, after that the value of this is nothing but the 21.21 minus 22.498, and plus the value of this is nothing but the 10. So now just do the calculation of all this term. So you will get the value of summation of Fy, that is nothing but the 33.71 newton. So once you get the value of some horizontal forces and vertical forces, then you can easily find out the resultant of magnitude of resultant of force. So we know R is equal to under root of summation of fx square plus summation of fy square, right? So here put the value of both terms, that is nothing but minus 30.7 square plus 33.71 square. Then do the calculation of this term, then you will be get the value of R, that is nothing but the 45.59 Newton, right? So here once you get the resultant, you have to do to find out the direction of resultant forces. Direction of resultant force. So for that we are using the formula theta is equal to tan inverse of summation of fy divided by summation of fx, right? So put the value of these terms, right? So you will be get the value of theta. So here theta is equal to tan inverse of 33.71 divided by minus 30.7. So you will be get the value of theta, that is nothing but the minus 47.67. But this is not our actual value of the theta. So you can see here, since summation of fx is a negative and summation of fy is positive, therefore resultant lines between 90 degree and 180 degree, right? So here you can see summation of fx is negative, this is the your fx negative and this is the fy positive. So this is 90 to 180, in between this your direction of resultant force. So here actual angle is nothing but theta is equal to 180 degree minus 47.67, that is nothing but the 132.3 degree. So this is the value of theta. So here our problem number 8 is complete. In the next lecture we will see the non-orthogonal components. Okay, thank you.